But one thing that I thought would be really interesting to ask you, because I believe you're the only player that's played in both leagues this season, LEC and LCS, is like, how much higher is the level of LEC compared to LCS? Like, do you feel it as a player? Is it just like another fucking world? Like, how does it actually, like, what was the experience of playing in both?
Well, the thing is, like, I watched a bit of NA here in summer as well, and it looks like the level is higher than in spring, because in spring, I think the level was, like, just terrible, to say the least. Like, I think we were even terrible, and we got fourth place. I think only Cloud9 had, like, an actual really good level. So obviously the difference was huge when I got here, and I mean, even though teams like G2 and Fnatic were kind of slumping, there were still, the level was still higher, I felt.
Yeah,
but I don't want to overstate it as well, because I think spring was like an exception. I do believe NA is better now, but better than EU, probably not.
So what makes you actually believe that NA is better now? Is it just the fact that Cloud9's dropping games? You have like these other teams that are competing with Cloud9. Like, is that where you're drawing your comparison, or are you just watching the games and you think like the overall just macro is better, the decisions and, you know, like laning phase, etc.?
I'm just watching the games, and I think teams like Liquid and TSM, they look better. They look like decent teams at the very least. And that's not something I could say in spring split, because there was Cloud9, and then second place team, whoever the fuck that was, EG, Fly, TSM, whoever it was, I would say this team is really bad. But I don't feel like it's the same now. I feel like you have two or three like decent teams at least.
Yeah, that's something I would definitely agree with. This, like, it's not just about Cloud9 losing, because listen, if the top team loses, obviously it's going to make it by the standings look more competitive. But I would agree, if you just look at the way that the teams who were, like, when Cloud9 was number one, if you looked at the teams that were 2, 3, and 4 in both the splits, summer split looks way better. Like, the TSM that he was talking about was the one that everyone used to say should be the second best, but then half of the games they would just be shit. The other half they'd look really good, then they just look terrible in the other ones. Then you had, obviously, like he said, Evil Geniuses, they were mad up and down. FlyQuest, like, the problem with FlyQuest is they're just like the team that you're supposed to feel good about if they're like the fourth best team. Like, oh wow, congrats, yeah, you guys are sort of doing it. You'll never win, but yeah, good, well done, yeah. But if they're your second best team, fucking hell, like, that end of that split was a mad indictment on how bad it was. Whereas, like, I've been saying all the time, everyone loves to say that Team Liquid, like, oh, they were just winning all these close games. Yeah, if that was actually a team you liked, you'd just say they were clutch, you fucking disingenuous motherfuckers. Like, when you win all the games that are close, guess what? You're really good. That's actually a fucking sign that you're good. I get that, like, so, certain parts, like, for example, with their team, you could obviously say their early game was shit, they weren't doing anything with the jungler. I'm with you on that, but, like, they still had strengths. There's a reason why no one can fucking kill them in the late game.
Yeah, I've been like up and down on TL. Like, when you look at TL and like how they're playing right now, the fact that they don't have a consistent early game and that they kind of just win by having like better players mid to late, I feel like is super worrying, because when you play against like the top teams in the world, when you look at like the people that are gonna be their competitions at like just even in EU, you can look at a team like Rogue or Mad Lions, and they do have solid early games. Like, their junglers are extremely active on the map, and you can just tell that they're like progressing the game. They're way better at accelerating the game than TL. Whereas when you see TL, even when TL plays like a shit team, like a dead last team, like they did last week, they played Immortals.
They didn't stomp anyone. Yeah, let's be real.
Yeah, it's just, it is literally just a snooze fest for the first 45 minutes of the game, and, you know, they're almost throwing the game. I mean, surely they end up winning, but, I mean, beating a bunch of rookie players in a close 45-minute game, I feel like is almost expected, and it just doesn't give you a lot of confidence when you watch the other regions and you just compare it. So I guess that's why people are low on Team Liquid. I'm nervous for NA. I mean, maybe I'm just North American and I've been let down so many goddamn times that I just refuse to have any type of hope at this point. But when I look at our region, it looks pretty doomed going into Worlds. Like, the only hope I have is if, like, Cloud9 get back on form, that they could maybe do some damage. That's the only hope I have.
Yeah, but the thing is, Dom, here's the factor that everyone keeps forgetting, which is why you can actually have hope that Cloud9 could get their form back, is In the playoffs, especially if they ever end up in the lower bracket, you can play as many games in the playoffs in NA now as you did in the entire regular split. So you got a lot of time to get your shit together. You might play like 3 or 4 best of 5 series. So actually, in theory, everything could change. That's the stupidest thing. And the patches are all going to change. Like, to me, there's so many extra reasons now. Now it's like a real postseason, like hockey or fucking basketball. It's not like the old one. Like, remember when you first started playing and it was like... Yeah. Dude, you had to win like 2 best of 3s and you were in the final, or 1 if you'd already had the seed. Like, that was ridiculous.
Yep. Hey, I mean, that was so weird, because best of 3s felt Like, how often do you see a team go up 2-0 and they get reverse swept? You'd come out and, like, play two matches or play the first two games, have two different strategies. You could just play poorly one game, get, like, you know, shit on in draft the next, and it's like, all right, go home. That's it. There's no lower bracket or anything, so. See ya.